Hi there, welcome to Lipstick Lounge. Today we are going to take our 1920s Downton Abbey daytime look into an evening look. So a 1920s evening look, very Great Gatsby. So we're going to go for nice smoky dark eyes and a really dark lip as well. So we're going to enhance the look a wee bit by adding some contour. We're going to focus really on the eyes and on the lip colour as well. Hope you enjoy. So just get started. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to focus on the eyes to start with. Because my model Laura has hazel eyes, I'm going to be using a lot of greys, pinks and purple tones as well, just to really bring out the colour of her eyes. So to start with, I'm going to start with a really nice dusty rose colour from MAC. And the trick with doing a 1920s smoky eye is the colour gradient actually starts from light and works its way to dark, and what you do to the top you do to the bottom. A big massive part of 1920s makeup is this dome shape of the eye. It's to make the eyes look wider and larger and more kind of whimsical. So if you close your eye for me, I'm going to start in the crease area and I'm going to take that right in the crease. I'm pretty much following the shape of the brow, bringing it right into the inside corner as well. And you want that product to come quite far out as well. I know it feels quite strange to do, but it looks amazing once it's done. And you really need that base so that your gradient will flow nicely. This is a look that builds up and builds up. So when you're applying the colour, don't get too lost in the precision of it. You really, really have to get that product as far out and underneath the eye as you can, because you're layering and layering, and the darker the colour you put on, the less obvious the colour you put on before is. So don't worry about putting too much product in your eyes. That's actually preferable. Please do that. So like I'd said, what you do to the top, you do to the bottom. So you're taking the same colour, and if you just look up for me, right from the inside corner, you're bringing that right the way down. So that is your base down. So you're going to move on and do your next step, which is one shade darker, or two shades darker, depending on how deep you want to go. The second colour there, it's a smoky purple tone. And again, I'm going to go into the crease of the eye, bring that all the way around. So I'm going to start going in with the greys now. I'm going to start off using the matte grey first of all, just to give a little bit of definition. And then I'm going to go in with a kind of shimmery grey, just so when the eyes blink, you've still got that kind of differentiation between the dark liner colours and the shadow colours. And because I've already got the eyeliner on, I'm going to go over it a wee bit just to make it a wee bit wetter, because we're going to spread out the shadow using a black pigment as well. So just close out for me, just a check. I'm going to make it ever so slightly a wee bit darker. And to do that, I'm going to use a kind of deep purple. And this colour is getting taken across the lid this time. Most of the time we've been keeping the colour concentrated into the crease area, but this one is coming down onto the lid. You're really, really trying to build up the colour underneath to make that eye look really, really open. So I'm going to put some more eyeliner on. Just close your eye for me. I'm going to go over the top of that liner with, it's called Beauty Mark, it's a purple, really, really dark black purple from MAC. It's a wee bit sparkly, it's lovely. So once you've set the liner with that colour, then you want to start blending it up towards the eyelid as well, just to give it that really nice smoky gradient. I always use a liquid liner when doing this, purely because you get nothing darker than a jet black liquid liner, and you still want that definition at the eyelashes. You want it to be different from the shadow. So same as always, if you do it to the top, you do it to the bottom. Just look up. And you see that I'm coming, see right where the corner of the eye is? You really want to make that quite dense, because this look, because you're using so many dark colours, you think it's going to close the eye over, but the nature of 1920s eye makeup is it makes the eyes look massive compared to the tiny lips. It's that kind of contrast. So you really want to pull that shadow as far out as you really can get it, so you're pretty much drawing yourself a new eye shape. And when you get to the inside corner, you're wanting to just elongate that ever so slightly. And blend it under. If you haven't applied enough of the previous colours, you can absolutely go back in and just touch up the lighter colours. I am going to go back in and just underneath the eye top up with some of the pinks and purples that I had used previous. I'm going to pop a bit more mascara on as well. It does help if you've got quite thick lashes for this, it's good. Just look down a wee bit. And just remember, when you're doing the lashes, you need to get the inside lashes as well as the outside. So I'm just going to apply some coal liner. I'm just going to apply that into the actual waterline. So if you just look up for me. And I'm just going to dot this in between the eyelashes as well, and then go back in with my angled brush. And it is a massive difference from the other eye. So we've finished doing the dark smoky eye makeup, and we're now going to move on and do a wee bit of sculpting, very, very minimal sculpting for 1920s, but you really want to differentiate between the daytime look and the nighttime look. So you want those cheekbones and that jawline to really, really pop. So I'm going to use a matte bronzer, just by MAC, with my tulip brush, and I'm going to do a bit of contouring. So find your cheekbone and you want to start sculpting under. You want to move the brush with the natural contours of your skin. And then bring it down onto your jawline as well. And you want to pull that from the centre part of the jaw towards the chin, and then again towards the ear. You don't want too much product back here because it'll look unnatural. You just want to really, really etch this bit here out. I'm just going to top up the blusher that we had in the previous look. So still pink, still keeping it to the centre of the cheeks there. There we go. And we're going to change the lip colour as well. So we're going to go from that kind of nice dark red into a dark plum, topped with a red lipstick. I'm just going to pop a bit of lipstick over the top of that. So still using the Dubonnet colour, just because it's a great colour for this look. But this time, instead of putting it on top of a pale lip, we're putting it on top of a dark lip liner. So there you have it, that is your 1920s daytime look transformed into your Gatsby look. Remember, when creating this look, that you want to really elongate the eyes using the shadows rather than using the eyeliner. So when you're using your shadows, keep that dome shape, but bring it quite far out, almost touching the eyebrow. And you want to take your gradient, instead of it going from light to dark, you want to take it from dark to light. So you always start with your lighter colours and work your way down to the base of the eye. And always remember, what you do to the top, you have to do to the bottom. So you're really trying to create that really, really smoky, smoky eye. And the other wee tips are, keep your blusher in the centre of your cheeks, contour just at the sides and just on the jawline here, and take your lip from any kind of red into a deep plum, or a really, really dark, dark plum, or a dark, dark, dark red, and that'll give it more of an evening look and tie with the Gatsby look. There you have it. That is your 1920s Great Gatsby inspired look.